Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am going to share with you one of my favorite green juice recipes. This recipe is great for removing estrogen dominance from the body because of the ingredients that we're going to use. It helps with alkalinizing the body, menstrual pain, menstrual bleeding, heavy menstrual cycles, you name it. It helps the reproductive system all the way around. So if you want to see how I make it, stay tuned. We're going to start off with a small head of cabbage, and we're going to cut around the core, although I think you can juice the core. There's nothing wrong with juicing the core of the cabbage. It's not the same as eating the core. The only reason I think people take the core of the cabbage out is because they don't want to chew on that. But since it's going through the juicer, it's not going to make any difference. So you can use either the green cabbage or you can use the red cabbage. I think the red cabbage even has more nutrients in it than the white cabbage or the green cabbage. But what I'm going to do here is cut up my cabbage to fit my juicer. I like to cut it up small because cabbage has like a texture that sometimes is hard to get into the mouth of my juicer, so I usually just cut it up pretty small, and that way it'll be easy to use. This juice makes about 4 cups of juice. It really is going to depend on what kind of juicer you have. I have a Green Star juicer. Love my juicer. You guys will see that in a minute. I had to go get a bigger bowl because this little bowl is not going to hold all of my produce. I don't know what I was thinking whenever I set up for the video, but anyway, I'll put a link below in the description box with the exact juicer that I have and love. Some of you have been asking for a review of that juicer, the Green Star, and I promise it's coming. So I'm getting this cabbage cut up and put in the bowl. And I'm going to move on to the next ingredient in the juice recipe in just a second. But I want to tell you that I'm going to share with you the benefits of the cabbage and why I think that this is such a powerful juice. And it's not just my thinking. It really is. It's researched. So the next ingredient is 2 apples. Now, if you like a sweeter juice, you can add another apple. That's going to give you a little bit more juice. But for this recipe, for me, because I don't like things too sweet or too green, this is perfect for my taste buds. But you can always add an additional apple to this juice recipe. And that's the thing about juice recipes. You can play with them. They do not have to be accurate. If you don't like apples, you can use pears. That's a perfect substitution for an apple. But you do need something to go in here that is going to sweeten up that cabbage. I mean, you can drink straight cabbage juice. I've done it before. It's not for the faint at heart, but it's doable. And the same thing with the lemon. You can add another lemon. The lemon also, what that'll do, if you don't want it sweeter and you're trying to get rid of the green taste, if you add an additional lemon, or if you add lemon in general, it's going to counteract the green taste in the juice. And that's especially good for people who are really starting out with their juicing journey and they're like, oh, this juice is disgusting because it doesn't taste like Kool-Aid, or it doesn't taste like some kind of bar, you know, jarred juice or canned juice that you're used to drinking, because it's not easy changing your taste bud palate. I know all about that. I was addicted to all kinds of garbage before I started juicing. And if I'm not careful, I could go right back down that road. So that's why I'm, you know, so pretty militant about what I am putting in my body. So here is the juice recipe. This is for 4 cups of juice. It's a head of cabbage. It's 2 apples and 1 lemon. And you can add more or less of any of these ingredients You can drink it on an empty stomach. You can drink it with your meal. You can drink it throughout the day. There's nothing special that you have to do with this juice. And these are some of the questions that I get whenever I post juice recipe videos. So that's why I'm sort of answering them now. But my preferred way to drink juice is to drink it as a meal replacement, either for breakfast or for lunch. I have drank it with a meal, but I think it's best to drink it on an empty stomach because it goes straight to the bloodstream and gives you all of the nutrients and vitamins that you need. Okay, on to why this juice recipe is going to help you with your menstrual health issues. First off, cabbage is rich in a compound called DIM. Some of you even take DIM. But what DIM does is it helps you to metabolize excess estrogen in your body. So that right there, taking it and making it go in a juice form, it goes straight to your bloodstream and it's pushing excess estrogen out of your body, which is what you want to do. So that's not only good for the women's health issue, it's also good for helping you to reduce your risk of cancer because, believe it or not, a lot of people get cancer because they've got estrogen dominance in their body. And it's not just in women, it's in men too. So this juice not only would be great for women's health, it's good for men's health too. So give it to your husband, your boyfriend, whoever you've got to give it to, your mom, your dad, whoever. So the other thing that they're always telling women to stay on top of is their bone health. And I'm sorry to break it to you, but cow's milk is not going to do that for you. No matter how many times they've told you eat and drink dairy, that's not going to save your bones. The reason your bones are breaking down is because your body is acidic. So not only will juicing in general help with bone health, but this juice in particular is loaded with calcium, magnesium, and vitamin K, which helps to build the bones. The other thing I want to talk to you about too is when you lose blood every month, whether or not you're losing a lot or a little, you lose all kinds of nutrients whenever you bleed. And those nutrients need to be replaced. So most of the time when you go to the doctor and you get your iron levels checked and you find out you're either low in iron or anemic, they give you iron pills to replace it. But what about all the other minerals that you've lost from bleeding? So that's why it's important to juice, because when you juice, you get a super concentrated punch of vitamins and nutrients that you cannot even eat because you don't have enough room in your stomach to take in all of those fruits and vegetables. You just don't. So that's why juicing helps to restore the body the fastest when you're trying to heal yourself with nutrition. The next thing that happens to women, especially if they are bleeding a lot, and I'm talking about bleeding more than, you know, 2 to 5 tablespoons the entire period, the blood pressure starts to get affected. It might not get affected like right away, but usually as you're losing blood and your body's trying to keep up with making blood and trying to compensate for all the loss of nutrients, your blood pressure can start to fluctuate. I have talked to so many women who said they have fibroids for years, or they have really large fibroids and they're bleeding a lot and they're, you know, scared because the doctor's trying to put them on blood pressure medication. Well, that's what happens when your blood is, when you have low blood in your body, or and when you get these blood transfusions and then as you have low blood again because you haven't corrected the problem, your blood pressure starts to get messed up. Well, cabbage is one of those things that will help with maintaining good blood pressure. The other thing that helps with blood pressure is nourishing your kidneys, cleaning your kidneys, but we can talk about that in another video. Comment below if you want a video on how the kidneys affect your blood pressure. So I could go on and on and on and on about this cabbage, but I'm not going to do that. But I'm going to tell you a few more things and then we're going to end this video. The thing that it does, the cabbage does, is it boosts detoxification, which you need if you're trying to heal from women's health issues. The other thing is it promotes bowel regularity. A lot of y'all think y'all are regular. And let me tell you, if your digestive system was working optimally, let me just tell you this, you would not be struggling as much as you are with these female health issues. Going to the bathroom once a day is not enough. Sometimes going to the bathroom three times a day is not enough. It just depends on how toxic your body is. So if you need some help in the bathroom department, this cabbage is going to help with that. And also, it's going to help clear up the digestive tract in general with all the other issues that people have. One of the things that I notice that happens with women is that they think they are regular. They think they're regular. They think that they don't have to detoxify their bodies. They think that they can continue to live the lifestyle they are currently living and things are supposed to change in that area. And it just won't. It just doesn't happen that way. You have to take care of your body, especially if you've allowed yourself to get to this place where you're so toxic, you've got large fibroids in your body. And I'm not just talking about physical toxicity, I'm talking about emotional toxicity as well. That contributes to fibroids just as much as physical toxicity, if not more. In future videos, I am going to start talking about that more, because I've learned so much over the last year that I have so much to share. It's just ridiculous. These fibroids are robbing people of their lives. Just think how much of your life has been stolen because you couldn't do certain things because you were controlled by this problem. Whether it be you couldn't go outside because you were afraid you're going to bleed through your pants, or you didn't take risks and go places and experience things because you were too afraid. I mean, the list goes on and on. So there's so many more things I could say about cabbage, but here's what I am going to say. It can help with your skin, hair, and nails, your stomach. It can help heal acne. And it helps with overall immunity. And if you're looking to lose weight, it'll help you with that as well. One day in the near future, I will do a live on this one because I think it's really, really an important topic to talk about because it really does help people. But if you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend. Don't forget to subscribe. And also, if you want more juice recipes, the link is below to get my Juicing for Women's Health ebook, and the link is up above in the information bar as well. So until next time, y'all, take care. Much love.